Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. This is Atriox, and we're back with another reaction. So, we're gonna be doing Element, the OG version. One of the commenters in the last Kendrick Lamar video said that they think I should check this one out. And I was like, you know what, why not? I haven't done a Kendrick Lamar song in almost 2 weeks, so like, I kind of really want to do that. Cause I so far, every Kendrick Lamar song I've heard so far, it's been awesome to me. And obviously, being somebody who like came, you know. I was raised with hip-hop and metal, even though, like, this channel was mainly a metal reaction channel. I do enjoy going back to, like, you know, listening to some rap on it, too. So, you know, see, Kendrick Lamar is, like, a breath of fresh air to me. I grew up on Tupac, Biggie, you know, Eminem. Those are, like, the kind of rappers that I listened to growing up. As, you know, I'm 34 and all that. So, like, it's cool to see, you know, a newer generation still kind of embrace that, like, same kind of vibe that they gave off, you know what I mean? So... yeah, we're gonna check this out. This is Kendrick Lamar's Element, the OG version. I actually have the lyrics pulled up, because you guys know I'm not a breakdown channel. Like, I'm really here just for the vibes and just, like, you know, enjoying the music and just talking about my opinion and, like, how the song makes me feel and all that. So, without further ado, we're gonna jump into it. If you guys like this, you guys want to see more, you know, just leave more songs in the comment section below. We have a few songs we're gonna catch up to, but, you know, depending on, like, how people are feeling about the songs, we'll pick a different song each time. But anyways, guys, this is The Element, and we're gonna jump into it.
I don't give a fuck. I'm willing to die for this shit. I done cried for this shit. Might take a life for this shit. Put the Bible down and go out for a knife for this shit. D.O.T. my enemy won't catch a vibe for this shit. I been stumped out in front of my mama. My daddy commissary made it to commas. Bitch, all my grandma's dead. So ain't nobody praying for me. I'm on
I been stomped out in front of my mama is crazy, bro. Like, that's wild. Getting... oof, fuck, dude. Like, that's hard, bro. I'm not gonna lie. I'm gonna go back a little bit.
My daddy commissary made it to commas. Bitch, all my grandma's dead. So ain't nobody praying for me. I'm on your head.
I ain't gonna lie. I felt that, bro. My grandmother on my mother's side, she's technically alive. But, you know, in terms of, like, I don't really fuck with my grandmother on my mother's side just because, like, you know, we lost contact over a lot of things. Like, you know, we just weren't seeing eye to eye anymore, which is kind of like what I said on the original Kendrick Lamar reaction. We did the first one was like, I don't really get along with certain parts of my family. And that's one of the people with my grandmother. So, like, in terms of, like, you know, I don't really talk to him. So to me, like, in that way, like, it's kind of like I feel what he's saying there. I don't really have, like, you know, grandmothers that have to pray for me and all that stuff. I felt that, bro. Like, I felt that.
Praying for me, I'm on your head. 30 minutes later, no defense watching. Auntie on my telegram, like, be cautious. I be hanging out at Tams, I be on Stockton. I don't do it for the gram, I do it for Compton. I'm willing to die for the shit, nigga. I take your fucking life for the shit, nigga. We ain't going back to broke, family selling dope. That's why you mini ass rap niggas better know.
Hold on, I lost this lyric. Only have the first verse. That's kind of ridiculous. Hold on, let me see if I can find a second verse real quick. Let's go back a little bit.
Imaginary rich nigga, ay. Seven figures, how that slimmer than my bitch figure, ay. Going digital and physical and all y'all, ay. Fuck subliminals, I put you on that roll call. French, my talent speaking on me in interviews. Very cynical, dry hating, something I don't approve. Trying to get through silences on my Grammy night. Another dead prophet, hoping the God to give him life. Big Sean keep sneak this and I let it slide. I think his false confidence got him inspired. I can't make them respect you, baby. It's not my job.
Nah. He killing them, bro. What the fuck? Yeah, I definitely seen that interview with French Montana was speaking on Kdot. Like, I saw somebody react to that. All the people that was, like, speaking on Kdot and why people don't like Kdot. Which, yeah. I mean, he apologized. Did he apologize? Was that an apology? I don't know. It was something. J Jay Electronica put Silence on the Grammys night, yeah. And then Big Sean sneak dissing. Yeah. I don't listen to a whole lot of Big Sean music, so I can't really say if that was the case or not. Like, I know there's things like, you know, he feels some type of way about, you know, I think the Control verse, I think it was, people always say, like, I haven't listened to that song, but I've always heard that Control verse, people always said that Kdot killed him, and I guess, you know, in that way, Big Sean could, like, feel some type of way about that, because he's like, yeah, he didn't kill me, bro. Because, you know when rappers on the same song, like, you can't get killed on your song, like, you, like, it don't look good, like, just look at the Jay-Z Eminem situation there, like, you know, yeah, you just... can't do that, bro. I definitely get why Big Sean would feel some type of way about that, and even like get to the point where he's like almost sounds like he sneaked this in, you know what I mean? But this is crazy. I'm glad he reacted to it. Like, I'm not gonna lie, bro, like, just listening to Kendrick Lamar and him just handle the beef with Drake, bro, like, he's such a fucking strategic dude, bro. Like, he does shit for a reason, bro. I think it's false confidence got him inspired. I can't make them respect you. Actually, baby, I'm gonna go back a little bit. Slimmer than my bitch figure, ay. Going digital and physical and all y'all, ay. Fuck some criminals, I put you on that roll call. French, my talent speaking on me in interviews. Very cynical, dry hating something I don't approve. Jay Electronica through silences on my Grammy night. Another dead prophet, hope with the God to give him life. Big Sean keep sneak this and I let it slide. I think it's false confidence got him inspired. I can't make them respect you, baby, it's not my job. You're finally famous for who you date, not how you rhyme, boy. Cute ass raps, get your puberty up. They make you a classic album before you come at us. Drake and McMill beef might got you gassed up, but I'm a whole nother beast, I really fuck you up. He was predicting the future, dog. Oh, that's such a bar, bro. Holy shit. When did this come out, bro? How long ago was this? Hold up. This is someone just posted this. I don't know how old this song is, but... Ah, dude, that's crazy, bro. It's like he predicted this shit. It's like, he told, like, yo, Drake, stay in your lane. Handle your little beef with Meek Mill. Like, I know that shit might have gotten you gassed up, but I'm a whole nother beast, bro. Like, I'll really put these hands on you, bro. Like, should have listened, bro. He should have listened, bro. But now I'm a whole nother beast. I really fuck you up. I wish a nigga would. 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 That chorus is fire. I wish a nigga would. I wish a nigga would. I wish a bitch would. I wish a bitch would. I wish a bitch would. I wish a nigga would. I wish a nigga would. I wish a nigga would. This goes out for those who choose to use disrespectful views on the king of hip-hop. Fuck that, why try? Throw bleach in your eye, now you're brailing it. Fuck that light shit, I'm scaling it. Niggas thought they wouldn't go see me, huh? Niggas thought that Kdot real life is the same life they see on TV, huh? Niggas wanna flex on me and be in LA for free, huh? Next time they hit the 10 freeway, we need receipt, huh? Cause most of y'all ain't real, most of y'all go squeal. Most of y'all just envy, but jealousy get you killed. Most of y'all throw rocks and try to hide your hand. That passive aggressive shit only work for your fans. Because it's all in your eyes, most of y'all tell lies. Most of y'all on top, but none of y'all.
He said most of y'all throw rocks and try to hide your hands, the passive shit. Damn, bro. Oof, most of y'all throw rocks and try to hide your hands. That passive aggressive shit only works for your fans. He's talking to Drake fans right there. Top five, most of y'all know I tried to lift the black artist, but it's a difference between black artists and whack. None of y'all top five, most of y'all know I tried to lift the black artist, but it's a difference between black artists and whack artists. You hear my sense? Go to your room. Go to your room. I wish you never would. I wish you never would. I wish you never would. Oh, shit. The end, dude. This shit was fire, bro. That I kind of want to go back to that second verse, bro, and just like listen to that shit again, bro. When he was talking about French Montana. I can't make them respect you, baby. It's not my job. You're finally famous for who you did. My bitch figure, ay, going digital and physical and all y'all. Let's go back a little bit, right? To a bitch nigga, ay, an imaginary rich nigga. By the way, he comes into this. Hold on. We gotta go back here. I'm allergic to a bitch nigga, ay, an imaginary rich nigga, ay. He comes to the song, I'm allergic to a bitch ninja A, imaginary rich ninja A. Bro, that's wild, bro. Like, 7 figures, ho, that's slimmer than my bitch figure, ay. Going digital and physical and all y'all, ay. Fuck subliminals, I put you on that roll call. French, my chat is speaking on me in interviews. Very cynical, dry hating something I don't approve. Jay Electronica, through silences on my Grammy night. Another dead prophet, hoping the God to give him life. One thing I fucking love about Kdot, he's not afraid to call names. He gonna call you, he gonna say your name on the song, bro. I really like that part, bro. Cause like a lot of people, like when they dissing, they be throwing subliminals out. Like, I hate that shit, bro. Like, if you gonna diss somebody, don't be a bitch. Don't be a, like, to me that's some corny shit, bro. If you gonna diss somebody, say his fucking name, bro. Let him know he's talking to you. Like, you're talking to him, I mean. Like, cause like if you gonna diss somebody, like if you throw a subliminal, it's like a female gossiping at the job. You know what I mean? Like, you're gossiping about another dude. Like, that to me, that's what subliminals are. Like, to me, I don't respect that shit, bro. I'm gonna keep it 100 with you. If you gonna diss somebody, let him know. Like, be a man. Like, let him know. I don't fucking like you, bro. I don't like you, bro. So I'm saying your name on the song to disrespect you because I want you to know that it's me that it's coming from. When I see these subliminal rappers. Oh, this, you know who I'm talking to. To me, it's corny. I don't like that shit, bro. I don't like subliminal type, this. To me, it's very corny, and I think, like, you know, I think it's kind of, you gotta make you a little bitch made. I ain't gonna lie, bro. You're a little bitch made. If you can't say the rapper's name on the song, don't bring his name up. Plain and simple. Because to me, it just looks like you're scary, bro. Like, I'm gonna just be honest. That's the way I view it. Something I don't approve. Jay Electronica, through silences on my Grammy night. Another dead prophet, hoping the God to give him life. Big Sean keep sneak dissing, I let it slide. I think his false confidence got him inspired. I can't make them respect you, baby, it's not my job. You're finally famous for who you date, not how you rhyme, boy. Ooh, I didn't even catch that the first time. He said, I think his false confidence got him inspired. I can't make them respect you, baby. It's not my job. Obviously, it's your job. You didn't come hard enough on that song. That's basically what he's saying. And it's like, you're finally famous for who you date, not who you rhyme. Not how you rhyme. I don't know who he was dating at that time, so I can't really say. But I assume it's somebody super famous, obviously. Then, cute-ass raps. Get your puberty up. And then him going to this party. Cute ass raps, get your puberty up. They make you a classic album before you come at us. Drake and McMillan beef might got you gassed up. But I'm a whole nother beast, I really fuck you up. You should have listened back then. You should have listened to this man, and he wouldn't have had to embarrass and dismember your whole image like the way he did in this beef. And I'm not gonna sit here and say that Drake didn't get any, like, he didn't drop any good diss track. That's not true. I don't like TaylorMade. I don't like, you know, The Heart Part Sits. I don't like any of those. I thought those songs sucked. But that's my opinion. Family Matter I thought was good. I think Push Ups was good. Family Matter just unfortunately got the wrong end of the stick. Kendrick was ready for it, and he just outmaneuvered him. And then Kendrick dropping Not Like Us right after freaking Meet the Grams was just, it was kind of the nail in the coffin. And then, like, if Drake would have came back and, like, had a better song than, you know, hard Part Sits, maybe he could have, like, salvaged the beef a little bit. But because, like, at the end of the song, it just sounded like he was giving up. And, like, to me, the whole song in itself was, like, kind of him that's defending the whole time, not really taking shots. And you know, it was such a weird, like, feeling listening to The Hard Part Sits, because, you know, it just, the whole song just didn't feel like a diss, in my opinion. It felt like him just defending himself and just trying to, like, you know, like, plug all the holes that, like, he could to, like, kind of save his image from what Kendrick was doing. Because Kendrick was just hitting him. Because the thing, you know, I thought was funny. I know this is going to go to a tangent about the whole beef with Drake, but I'm going to go there. I think, you know, when he was on, like, was it a Push-Up? So he's like, drop, like, I don't think he understood what that meant, because, like, he was, like, trolling Kendrick, and the more he did it, I felt like, kid, I was like, alright, keep playing, you gonna find out why they call me the boogeyman. And sure enough, and then, like, the him calling out Whitney's name, I think this was a horrible idea.
It was just such a bad idea. But anyways, like, you know, let's, I do eventually want to cover the diss tracks on the channel. Like, maybe we'll do, like, you know, one long listen where we listen to a bunch of diss tracks and we'll just see, like, you know, just give our opinion on it. And, you know, with a more open mind. But anyways, guys, that's gonna do it for this video. This song was sick, bro. I'm not gonna lie. I'm definitely gonna listen to the song more to see whatever I missed. And especially that second verse. That second verse, I love that second verse. Like, him calling out all those rappers' names. Even though I like Big Sean, like, it's you know, don't be dry dissing, bro. Don't be throwing subliminals, bro. That's corny, dog. That's corny, bro. I ain't gonna lie to you, bro. That's mad corny. Anyways, I'm out of here, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this reaction. If you guys want to see more, just let me know in the comment section below. Let me know what other songs you guys want to see. We have a few songs. I do eventually want to do Control, and I want to do, I think it's called Mad City. I heard something like that. Like, one of my friends says it's a song I should react to since I'm reacting to Kendrick Lamar. But anyways, let me know what you guys want to hear in the comment section below. Hope you guys enjoyed this reaction, just my opinion on it. Like I said, like, I'm not a super hard, I don't do breakdowns like that because I don't really have, you know, I don't really have the necessary, like, ear and stuff like that for it yet, but maybe eventually one day. Anyways, guys, I'm out of here. I'll catch you guys. Peace.